Last campaigns here in Chigezi sub-region, he will be here in Rukungiri district. I will take you back to studios. My colleagues will be taking you for more of our programs. I'm Julius Kafuma, and my colleague Del Charigonze on camera. I will take you back to studios.
All right, thank you very much, Julius Kafuluma, there in Rukungiri District. And you're still watching Urban Today. Myself, Lynn Komlish, and Henry Sekanjako. Now, Kafuluma was meeting the chairman of the NRM in Rukungiri District, and that is Major General Jim Muhwezi. You know, he's been off the scene for a bit, but he's back.
Yeah. He's been MP, he's been minister.
Yeah. And then for some time he took a break, I think.
Because he had lost.
I thought it was a systematic
not
break.
At all. He had lost, now he's making a comeback. And look, when you just like in Tungam, it's a district where, you know, we have big wigs.
Big wigs, yes.
People like FDC's Dr. Kanochi is the best, he comes from that side.
Mm-hmm.
We're also seeing Jim Muhwezi and
Ingrid Turinawe, you know.
I think the problem is still persisting in this area. The things to do with infrastructure involvement is still bad. And then water supply is also still bad. You talked about hospitals.
Yeah.
And then there's also a growing trend about universities. You also talked about they need a public university
in the district.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to lobby for that.
One of the things that he's looking at, mm-hmm, to lobby government to put a public university there. And I think that's a good thing.
I think so.
Fort Portal is going to get one.
Yes, that is Mountains of the Moon.
Mountains of the Moon.
Yeah.
So I think
I think it's a good move.
It's a good move, so that we extend,
but,
you know, education services.
There's something Jim has mentioned, because Julius asks him that why is Lukunji still lacking on a few things, infrastructure, A, B, C, D, and Z. Then Jim says, you know, it is an opposition hub of sorts, and so those opposition figures are not in position
to lobby
to
for.
Lobby for
I get it.
For these services.
I
think it's a very interesting argument.
Mm-hmm.
But recently, this is going to be, today is going to be his last leg in
Chigezi.
In Chigezi, yes.
I'm sure so Rukungiri is part of Chigezi.
Yes.
It's a sub-region of sorts.
So it is Rukungiri, Kabale, Barara, Ntungamo. Yeah, there's Chigezi and then Ankole.
Okay.
Yeah, is in Ankole. Oh. So Chigezi, Rukungiri, Kabale, those ends is Chigezi.
Oh. So, you talked about the issue to do with the trade and Rukungiri being near DRC. You're saying the government is planning to construct the roads.
That's
to
true.
To ensure that, you know, people benefit from trade and all that. And I think it's a good thing.
Absolutely. Now, Henry, let's look at Friday. The nation, of course, led by the president, held prayers, national Thanksgiving prayers. And the president is where he said, I am not happy with the Electoral Commission.
That's true.
And police. So we realize that while he is observing SOPs, others are not. And that's very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, I'm not happy. Why are you not?
And those candidates will tell you that even us, we don't invite these people. We'll be moving and then people come.
And then the opposition is going to argue that it's not our fault that people are in support of us. And
you know, and the president says, okay, we know it's not your fault.
Okay.
But why do you get out of your cars to wave to these people?
To these people.
Just sit in your cars, drive on, and people will not be bothered.
But do you think summoning Chagulanyi and Amuriat is going to help in any way?
I don't think so. Chagulanyi had a meeting with EC.
Some time back. It's not even a month
and,
yet.
Yes, and the main issue was police were blocking him and all that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they talked about these very things that they want to tell him today.
Mm-hmm.
But he's supposed to appear there today, and then maybe something good will come out of it.
That's true. Very true. What stands out for you, though?
I think it's not going to change. They better let the guy go ahead and campaign, because I don't see Chagulanyi holding a rally somewhere and then people don't show up.
But now, Anyway,
I don't see it. I don't see it happen. And the campaigns, of course, heating up. Mm-hmm. Our producer Jimmy,
yeah, he's
becoming a campaign expert. In the morning, we're having a discussion, and then he said, "You know what? Now campaigns are starting."
This is when the campaigns
him, what has
started.
Been happening.
I'm thinking they started long ago.
So yeah. Anyway, Chagulanyi, he was also telling me that Chagulanyi, if he misses today, will be, you know, the number of districts that he has missed to campaigning,
yeah,
will be coming to 30. And I don't know how he's going to compensate for that.
I know.
Because he has lost a lot of time, and yes, he also misses out today.
We have very few days to voting day.
You said about 30?
About 30. If you visit the New Vision Digital Experience app, they'll definitely tell you how many days we have to go. But Henry, the president on Friday assured us that 2020 elections, because he had... People were asking him that there's a possibility we are not going to have peaceful elections.
Exactly. Everyone is looking at violence.
Yes.
That's going to be violent.
Yes. Mm. And this is one of the reasons he's actually blaming police and the Electoral Commission.
Sure.
But then he assured the nation that they're going to be peaceful. And coming from him, definitely, we know that is going to be no question.
Exactly. We look out forward to that. Because if people go vote peacefully,
yes,
you know, go vote, go back home,
mm-hmm,
I think we won't be able to see, you know, those scenes of violence coming up here and there.
Well, I will not leave without us mentioning police brutality method on journalists.
That's true.
And the president of the Uganda Parliamentary Press Association has written and said, stop police brutality against journalists.
That is very
and
important.
Other citizens.
Mm. Because when you go to cover these guys, we're only putting up a message out.
We are messengers.
We are
don't
messengers.
Shoot the messenger.
So if a police officer comes out and starts beating journalists, really beats my understanding. It's very uncalled for, if you ask
police
me.
Is going to give you excuses. Oh, they were not in the way we in the circle we had organized for
know.
Them. Like,
yeah,
you can see I'm a journalist. I'm wearing something showing that I'm pressed. Mm-hmm. Is it so hard? Do you need specs? I can help you with
it's
mine.
Very, it's very bad.
It's really bad.
Mm.
It's really bad. But yes, so that's it. Let's take a break now. When we return, we look at what's happening in the sporting world. Welcome back. Urban Today it is. You're in time for Urban Sports, and joining me is Becky Cynthia Nachimera. Becky, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm good. How was your weekend?
Not bad.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is now getting, you know, better and better, especially in the sporting industry.
Okay, maybe
yes,
that. Maybe
because
that.
We are seeing lots of activities coming back. We saw the Masaza returning. And the official opening was graced by the Kabaka of Buganda, Ronald Moen Mtibi, at Njeru Technical Center. We are seeing fans back on the pitch. This was first seen in the West Ham game and versus Manchester United, where they allowed about 2,000 fans, and we are seeing it back here. As long as you paid for a season ticket, you were allowed at the stadium. KCCA allowed 200 fans in the Mbarara City KCCA game at the Philpo Mondi Stadium. And I think this is a very good gesture, because this is what people have been missing. And if we go on like that, but of course respecting the SOPs, I think it is good to go. In the English Premier League, we saw lots of games played over the weekend. I'll just give you the results. Southampton beat Sheffield United 3-0. Crystal Palace and Tottenham shared the spoils 1-1. We understand that Tottenham is top on the league log. Fulham and Liverpool all shared the spoils 1-1. And Burnley beat Arsenal 1-0. Arsenal is lying 15th on the league log. We understand it had a good start. My producer is smiling, I know. It had a good start, but unfortunately, we are seeing it, you know, go down. And Manchester United trying to, you know, put up the levels. It's now lying eighth on the
when
league.
When you
log.
Say lying, it already looks bad.
It already looks bad. That is Uganda Premier League. The games are still ongoing.
Okay.
We are having many games played over the weekend. We saw the return of Shaban Mohammadi, the Vipers player. He calls himself Mo Shaban, Mo Salah.
Okay, yes.
We understand, we know the rate work of Shaban Mohammadi, with no doubt. He's a goal scorer, he's a goal poacher. And when he was given his first debut in the Wakiso Giants game, he gave a good header, and that gave Vipers the 1-1 on Saturday, which was a very good gesture. So we are seeing him return. We are yet to see what he's going to offer. We had Police FC also beat Chitara 5-0. Chitara is the newly promoted club in the Uganda Premier League.
Yes.
We saw Villa was beaten by URA. That is 2-1. We are seeing URA get its first win ever since we resumed the league, because we have been seeing URA drawing with all the teams it has been facing.
Okay, that's very interesting. And a whole lot of sporting
exactly,
activities.
Yes.
Though I'm worried about COVID-19.
COVID-19.
And with allowing
I can assure you is I'm one of the people who always attends the matches. And what I can attest is there is social distancing.
Okay.
That is the truth. Okay. And if you can't comply, you will be just chased out of the stadium. Maybe elsewhere, that is the netball world, the league was cancelled last week, and it was postponed up to 2020 because of the clubs failing to avail COVID-19 results. Yes, we only had Police and NIC. They're the only ones that had tested.
Is it because they are not able to test?
Of course, the fans are not there. We understand netball has been suffering a lot. Even our national team is one of the teams in the sporting industry that has suffered a lot. Even when we qualify, you know, we struggle a lot to get the fans that help the girls in the camp and elsewhere. So we see netball postponed up to next year.
Okay. That's it for the sporting world. Do take care of yourselves. Wash your hands. Wear that mask, I beg your pardon. Wear your mask as soon as you get out of your house. And you can also wear it in your house if you're suspicious of the people in your house. But yes, be very careful. COVID is here and it is everywhere. So you better look out for yourself. Otherwise, I don't know where you're going to get me. I don't know. I can't get 5 million to spend in ICU every day. People, be warned. Seriously. And I'm going to tell you this every day. Thank you, though, for watching Urban Today. I will catch you definitely tomorrow from myself and the team. It's a good week and a beautiful day.